Do More and the new C302 module take all of the hassle out of programming motion, and it's so easy. For these examples, we have a stepper motor driving a threaded rod, which pushes a carriage along a rail. There's also an encoder and a proximity sensor that we'll use in some of the later videos. Check out the hardware video for a list of all the parts we used and a wiring diagram. Let's go ahead and do the jog function. I went ahead and set up a new online project for us to use. Step 1, you need to configure the module. There's a number of ways you can do that. You can say right-click, System Configuration, or PLC, System Configuration, or the easiest thing is just hit the Configure button. And here we want to modify the module configuration. So I click on Module Configurations and I see all the modules in my rack. Well, in this rack we only have the one C3O. So we type in a name here, I've already done that, C3O Demo, and we configure the I.O. Here are all my inputs, here are all my outputs. I want to dedicate outputs 0 and 1 to a pulse and step direction output. I can unassign them, pulse direction, whatever I want. That's all we need for now is to assign these two to drive the stepper motor. So that was step 1, module configuration. Very easy. Step 2, we need to set up our profile. Well, in the Do More Designer, there's a command called ctaxis config. And we just fill in the blanks. Here we put the C3O module we want to use. Of course, we only have one in the system, so that's easy. We say what's the minimum frequency? What frequency are we going to start issuing pulses at? What's the maximum frequency we want to achieve? This stepper motor has 20,000 pulses per revolution. So let's make our maximum frequency 200,000, which will be 10 shaft revolutions per second. Let's make our acceleration rate 400,000. So that the shaft be fully accelerated in half a second. It will make the deacceleration rate the same. We don't have any encoder feedback in this example, and we do want to initialize the output position at 0 when we first start this. So that's our profile. We're going to start this minimum frequency, ramp up to this maximum frequency, which is 10 shaft revolutions per second, at this acceleration and this deacceleration. And let's say we want to issue that command on the first scan. So step 1 was configure the module, step 2 was set up the profile, and for step 3, it's time to jog the motor. To do that, we use the counter timer, axis mode, jog function. So all we need to do is specify the output device. Of course, we only have one in our rack, so we select that one, and we're ready to go. That's all there is to it. We need to control this function, so I'll have input x0 enable the jog. And we'll have X1 be the forward direction, and X2 be the reverse direction. So one more time, we had to configure the module here, we had to set up our profile, and then we just issue the jog command. This little red triangle reminds you this is a fully asynchronous command. We don't have to do anything else. It does all the work for us. So let's try it. Let's accept all the changes. Let's save this. I'm going to save this as my jog demo and write it to the PLC. When we initially run this program, the config instruction is going to zero out that position. So I'm going to flip this thing to stop and back to run. And sure enough, our position went to 0. Now if we enable jog with X0 and I flip the forward switch, the carriage ramps up and ramps down. Hit the reverse switch, it ramps up to speed, and then ramps back down. That's it, doesn't get any easier. Please make sure your C302 firmware is up to date. Use the live update under help, check for updates, to make sure you have the latest files. I do, so there's nothing listed here. Once you've done that, go to PLC, Monitor C302 Module, and right here you can update the OS. If there was an asterisk next to that number, that would tell me it's out of date. I would hit this button and update the firmware on the C3O module. Well, that's all there is to implementing jog using the Do More in the C3O 2. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more on using motion with the Do More in the C3O 2. And as always, please send us any comments you may have. We appreciate the feedback. Spend less, do more from Automation Direct.